The future of technology is very, very small. As small as the atoms that make up everything around us, and sometimes even smaller. The rules of physics just seem to work differently at this level. And those rules, which we call quantum science, not only challenge our understanding of how the universe works, they offer world-changing potential. Today, scientists and engineers are starting to harness the power of quantum science to create technology that pushes the limits of what we thought was possible. Researchers are sending unhackable messages, working to create personalized drugs and ultra-precise cancer-detecting sensors, and developing quantum computers capable of considering billions of solutions in just fractions of a second.
In this tiny device are the building blocks for quantum computers, known as qubits. Like most futuristic technology, qubits used to only be theoretical. Now they are in labs all across the world, used in everything from sensing to communication to computation.
But quantum computers are still a relatively new technology. You can think of it like how computers in the olden days used to use punch cards and take up entire rooms.
Right, and that was really cool at the time. But our quantum technology is a little more advanced than that. But it's in a similar stage of development. And now that we have it, we are just starting to discover some of the amazing things we can do with it, like building a quantum internet.
And we're not just talking about quantum computers either. We can use the unique properties of quantum mechanics to make other advanced technologies, like super precise sensors. And we can use quantum mechanics to answer important questions in a ton of different fields of science, including physics, chemistry, biology, and even medicine. We've only just begun to scratch the surface and discover everything that quantum can do for us.
This field, our field, is called quantum science and engineering. And in this series, we're going to show you what it is, how it's possible, and how you too can become a quantum scientist. Hi, I'm Katie Sauter.
And I'm Robbie Weinbaum.
I'm a researcher at Argonne National Lab, and Robbie is a graduate student at the University of Chicago. And we work with teams of other quantum scientists and engineers to develop quantum technologies.
Ever since I first encountered quantum mechanics in my classes, I was mesmerized by it. It's just amazing to think that the universe behaves in such weird and counterintuitive ways if we just look at small enough scales.
Like you, Robbie, I also found the strange world of quantum mechanics fascinating. But as a materials scientist, I also wanted to learn more about how materials can be engineered to make new quantum devices.
I was also really curious about how quantum technologies could be used to address real-world problems like online privacy and security.
And it can also answer some really big questions we have, like how drugs interact with cells on the atomic scale.
Now, we know that all of this might sound a little bit like magic.
And it is pretty weird.
But that's just because physics has a completely different set of rules when we look at something as small as an atom or a molecule.
We can take advantage of those different rules to make technology that can do incredible things, like develop new LEDs and better solar cells, create unhackable code, and simulate problems across all avenues of science.
As we take you around the Chicago area to laboratories that are engineering solutions to these challenges, we'll dive into what some of those different rules actually are, and how we can use them to achieve things that we once thought were impossible.
And remember, you can use them too. We're at the beginning of the quantum technology revolution.
And we hope that by the end of our tour, you'll want to join us. Ready to go?
Let's do it.